Good morning to all. Welcome back to our course on the C programming language. In today's session, we are going to discuss about the multidimensional arrays. And in today's session, we are going to concentrate on only one topic, that is initialization of 2D arrays. We know what this initialization is. In the previous discussions, I told that the initialization is nothing but giving some initial values at the time of declaration itself. So initialization can be written as declaration where the memory will be allocated plus assignment. So you will give some values, initial values, by using the assignment operator. So initialization, as I told that, we can assume it as the declaration plus assignment in a single statement. In the previous examples, while discussing the concept of initializing a 1D array, we'll go to the initialization of 2D arrays. But before that, let me have a quick recap of initializing this 1D array. So in initialization of 1D array, we declare the array, a one-dimensional array. Let me say it is the array name is A, and the size of the array is 5. This is the declaration statement, and it should be followed by an assignment operator, followed by a list of values that are separated by commas. Since this particular array can hold 5 integer values, you have to initialize it with 5 values. This is the initialization what we have seen for the 1D array. And the first element will be stored in the 0th index. The second element will be stored in the first index. Similarly, this is second index, this is third index, and this is fourth index. So this is how the elements are going to be stored while you initialize it in the one-dimensional arrays. Now, our topic of interest in today's session is initialization of 2D arrays. The initialization of 2D arrays can be done in two ways. The first method is in the form of list of values that are separated by commas. We'll see it with an example also. So whatever elements you have, how many elements you have taken inside this 2D array, everything you will take it. That means, for example, if the 2D array what you have declared consists of 2 rows and 3 columns, in such case we know that that 2D array consists of 6 values, or it is capable of holding 6 values. So you will be initializing the entire 2D array with a list of 6 values. That is the first method. And the second method is, this is also a list of values only, but you will separate it in the form of rows. So you will give a separate pair of curly braces to represent the values of each and every row. Let me explain this with an example. So the first method, or the first way of initializing a 2D array, is by giving a list of values. We know that initialization is declaration plus assignment. So initially you have to declare an array. Let me declare an array as integer array, and the name of the array is A, which consists of 2 dimensions. One dimension is this square brackets, right? The first dimension represents the rows, we know all these things, and the second dimension represents the columns. Let me say that I have given 2 and 3 like this. That means this particular 2D array consists of 2 rows and 3 columns. So the total number of elements, as we know that the formula is row size into column size, that is 2 into 3, 6. and I need to initialize it. So I use an assignment operator followed by the parenthesis, and I know that it is capable, the A is capable of holding six values, integer values. So I give six different list of values that are separated by commas. This is the first method. Now let us see the memory representation of how it is going to happen, right? In the previous discussions, I told that the conceptual representation of 2D array is different from the practical representation. In practical representation, since you have six elements, every element will be stored in the contiguous memory locations like this, and this is 00, this is 01, this is 02, and this is 101112. This is the index numbers. The first index 00, the first index represents the row and the second index represents the column. So these are the six different elements we have. So in this, whatever first element you have given here, that is first 10, is stored in the 00 index like this, and the second element 20 is stored in the next index, that is 01. Here I store 20, and 30 will be stored in 02, 40 will be stored in the second row, that is 40 10 index, and at 11 index 50 will be stored, and at 12 index 60 will be stored. This is the physical representation of the arrays. But logically, what we'll do is we'll think of this memory as a table. As I told in the previous discussions, that whenever you want to represent the tabular data where you need to represent the rows and columns, then we are going for this two-dimensional arrays. So we represent it like this. This is the row index and this is the column index. So this particular cell is 0th row, 0th column. This is 0th row, 1st column. This is 0th row, 2nd column. And here it is 1st row, 0th column, 1st row, 1st column, and this is 1st row and 2nd column. Now the first element is stored in 0 index. The second element is stored in 01 index. The third element is stored in 02 index. Here 40, here 50, and here you will get 60. So this is how the elements are stored physically and conceptually when we initialize a two-dimensional array in the first way, like this list of values. And coming to the second method, the second way. The first method is very simple method where you just have to give a list of values, but it is not readable in nature. If you want to improve the readability of the particular statement, this one, then we need to follow the second method, that is list of values separated by rows. Let us see it with an example. We know that the initialization is equal to declaration plus assignment. So initially I will declare it. I'll take the same array int a of 2 and 3, and we'll use the assignment operator. It is common. And here what I will do is I will give a pair of curly braces for the entire list, and since there are two rows, I put it in two different lists like this. So this first pair of parentheses, curly braces, they represent the first row elements, and the second pair of curly braces, they represent the second row. In the first row, I want to initialize it with 10, 20 and 30. Why? Because I have only three columns. First row, three columns. And in the second row, three columns, 40, 50 and 60. So this is a cleaner way of representing the arrays. Right. You can see that you can easily identify what are the elements of the first row by looking at the first pair of curly braces, and what are the elements of the second row by looking at the second pair of curly braces. And the same thing, when we go for the conceptual representation of these two-dimensional array initialization, the same thing you have to do. This is the row number and this is the column index. And when you want to store, let me write the indices also. This is 0th row, 0 index, 0th row, first index. And this is 1, 0, this is 1, 1 and this is 1, 2. And now if I want to, since I have initialized like this, so 10 will be stored in 1, 0, 0 index, 20 is stored in 0, 1 index, 30 is stored in 0 to index, and 40 here, 50 here and 60 here. This is how the initialization happens. So these are the two ways of initializing a multi-dimensional array. This is the end of the topic, but before leaving the topic or before leaving this session, let us have a small discussion on a few important points. While discussing the concept of one-dimensional arrays, if I initialize an array like this, that is without specifying the size of the array, here I didn't specify any size, this particular initialization is valid initialization of arrays in the C programming language. That is, if you don't specify the size and you give the list of elements, then the compiler, when it comes across this point, it will come to know that it will definitely search for the size of the array, but it will go for the initialization and the number of elements that are initialized will be equal to the size of the array. So here the size of the A will be 4. The point what I am stressing here is, though you are not specifying the size of the array in the initialization of 1D array, still it is a valid statement. Why? Because the size of the array will be automatically taken by the compiler from the number of values that are initialized in the list. Let us see whether this type of initialization is valid in 2D array or not. So initially what I will do is, I declare a 2D array without specifying the row size and column size like this. When the compiler comes across this statement, it will raise an error. Why? Because you didn't specify the size of row and size of column. Though you have initialized it to 4 values, it will be confused whether it has to be 1 row 4 columns or 2 rows 2 columns like this. So without specifying the row size and without specifying the column size, the initialization of 2D array is completely invalid. Let me go with the second point. This time, what I'll do is, I will initialize the row size, but I don't give the column size. This particular initialization without specifying the column size but with specification of the row size is also invalid. this is also invalid. Let me take the last choice of initializing the 2D array without specifying the row size but specifying the column size, like this. You have specified the column size, and this type of initialization is perfectly valid in the C programming language. So the point what I would like to stress here is if you forget to give the row size, it is okay, but specification of the column size during the initialization of 2D array is mandatory. So this point is very, very important. So specification of column size is mandatory. So these are the very important points we can consider under this initialization of 2D arrays. The simple point you have to keep it in mind is specification of column size during the initialization of 2D array is mandatory. So by this we have completed the concept of initializing a 2D array. Let us have a quick recap of what we have done here. What we have discussed here, we started our discussion with the initialization definition, where it is equal to declaration plus assignment. We have seen an example of how we can initialize the 1D array, and we have gone through the two ways of initializing the 2D arrays, where the first method is initializing it with a list of values, and the second method is initializing it with a list of values with some separate lists for each and every row. Out of these two, the second method is the valid method, that is, it is more readable, not valid, it is more readable than the first method. So we have given an example of how we can initialize it with the first way and how the conceptual and physical representation happens after this initialization. And then we have gone through an example of the second way of initializing the 2D array, that is separate pair of lists for the rows, and we have seen how it is stored in the conceptual view. And finally we have ended up our topic with a very important point, that specification of column size is mandatory. And we have seen some examples where if you don't specify the row size and column size, it is not valid. If you don't specify the column size by specifying the row size, it is also not valid. But if you specify or if you initialize a 2D array by specifying the column size and without specifying the row size, it is a perfect valid statement. So that's all for today's session. Thank you one and all for joining the session.